The Bush and Troy Show.
It's Alex James here, hello.
Alex, yeah!
Is that the guy from that big band?
From Blur. Alex, can I just say, I don't want to sound like a sycophant, but you are the person who inspired me to pick up and play a bass guitar.
No way.
Honestly,
really?
Well, I was about 17 or 18, and up until that point, in terms of bass guitar heroes, you had Slap Bass and Mark King, and bass wasn't very cool. And then I went to the Roller Coaster Tour when you guys played in 1992 at Plymouth Pavilions with My Bloody Valentine, Dinosaur Jr. and the Jesus and Mary Chain.
Legendary show.
And suddenly, playing bass was cool again. And not genuinely, though, I went and got a bass guitar having watched you play. You were an amazing bass player.
Thank you very much indeed. Well, you know, bass player, it's quite easy, isn't it, playing the bass, really?
I have to explain to these guys, like, Alex was the first person that I'd heard properly play. I thought you played lead bass. I don't want to get too kind of muso on him, but.
Yeah.
And you never even looked at the strings. I had to put my tongue out and do the white man's overbite and really concentrate when I was playing. But.
And he hasn't stopped banging on about it since, Alex, I've got to say.
Yes.
Hey, you know, the new thing, the white man's overbite, the new thing to that is the tongue on the roof of your mouth. Tongue up into, that's the model thing. That's what the models do, yeah. So can you picture, you just push your tongue up into the roof of your mouth.
Oh yeah, and it gives you a kind of pouty look.
Yeah.
A look that would be described as maybe blue steel, something like that. I like that. Do you still play your bass guitar? I mean, since I stopped playing in a band, I don't play anymore, and I'm quite embarrassed by that.
It's a little bit sad playing bass on your own, and it's a bit like playing football on your own.
Yeah, you can't really do a lot.
Not be no mates. But I've been playing the ukulele. I've gone from the biggest instrument to the smallest.
Wow.
Hang on, a ukulele, what do you do with that? Is it like a... It's still like a guitar thing?
Yeah, it's like a little backpack guitar. I think they were from Hawaii. George Formby.
Oh, you know, now you're talking.
That's Pauline,
when
man
playing in windows.
Exactly.
Is this in a band, Alex, or just on your own in a room?
Just for my children, actually, yeah. Yeah.
Lucky them.
Lucky old them.
They're perfect audience children. You know, they just want you to do it again and they think everything's brilliant.
So I can see you on Christmas Day then, Alex, you and your kids sitting around the log fire and you playing Christmas tunes on your ukulele.
Frosty the Snowman. Yeah, you got it.
No, nice. I can see a Foster and Allen style Christmas album being released.
Have you ever thought about a lute?
Lute's a bit serious. Good thing about ukulele, it's silly. You know, you can't take yourself too seriously when you're holding a stupid little toy guitar.
But Alex, tell us about, obviously, Blur, you know, one of the best and biggest British bands of all time, and you guys had your ups and downs in that band. You know, you guys were drinking a lot, and then you straightened out and had huge success after that. I mean, how do you go from that kind of rock star existence to kind of overnight, you're just top of packed up, really, and you've gone and moved to the country and you live a completely different life now? Imagine some of your neighbours wouldn't even realise what you used to do.
Well, you know, I thought I was being kind of bold, because my wife and I bought a farm on our honeymoon, and I thought we were being quite bold and reckless, but I've since realised that it's just another cliche from the book of rock and roll cliches. Mm. It's just what ageing rock gentlemen do, is that, you know, they go and live on farms. You know, it's Paul McCartney, farmer. Mm. Sting, farmer. Roger Daltrey, farmer. It's what happens to you.
But Alex, they're not real farmers. They don't get their, like, muddy boots and then they don't go and, like, give birth to cows and all that sort of stuff. They're gentleman farmers, aren't they? You just sort of ponce around a bit in the local pub, don't you?
Yeah, well, you know, I mean, you know, all farmers are gentleman farmers. I mean, you can grow you can actually make a crisp from first principles. Like, you can be a potato farmer without getting any dirt under your fingernails. You know, it's all done by machines.
Yeah.
Which you just sort of switch on and watch.
So what kind of farmer are you? You're kind of like rough and ready, get stuck in farmer, or are you more of a dandy and hang out in the pub?
Finger farmer.
You're a finger farmer.
Yeah,
I like the sound of that.
You're not shooting pheasant on a Sunday morning with your musket and dressed in tweed.
I do. I mean, I don't know why anyone would eat chicken at this time of year when you can have pheasant, actually. It's like the ultimate kind of free-range organic but meat, really. You look at them, they've all been shot by kind of peers of the realm and company directors.
So is there anything that you miss then about the city life, or do you just think, thank God I'm out of the rat race and all that kind
taxis.
Of stuff?
Taxis.
Yeah, like going to the pub is a real nightmare, isn't
it? Yeah, it's a cycle. Yeah, it's chilly this time of year. I mean, you know, I think 10 years ago it would have driven me mad, 5 years ago even, but there comes a point when, you know, trees and violins and some peace and quiet sort of suddenly, you know, it's just getting old.
I saw you on a TV show the other week reviewing cheese, Alex.
Yeah, well, talking about cheese is, you know, that's been my sort of second life, really.
Oh, really?
Well, yeah, you know, I've always liked it, but I make cheese now, so I do, you know, people love cheese. I didn't realise how much.
I know, don't
they? I thought it was just me, but it's everybody.
But when you were in Blur, were you into cheese and just kept it quiet?
Was that on your rider?
It was, yeah, local. And they used to throw it at me in Japan, actually. So they throw, you know, they find out what you like and throw it at you. So
I love it.
George Harrison used to get jelly babies thrown at him.
Yeah. And you got a baby bell.
I got tin camelback. It's weird in Japan. It's strange.
Alex, can you give me a bit of advice then? When I go into my local deli in here in Bristol on North Street in Bedminster, they always have a massive thing of cheese called Stinking Bishop.
Very good cheese.
It scares the hell out of me. I've never had it. Can you recommend it?
I thoroughly recommend it. Yeah, it's made by Charles Martel from Gloucester Milk. It's the best new cheese this country's produced for quite some time. It's fantastic.
Wow.
I mean, it's quite smelly. I mean, you're in cheese country.
Yeah.
Be heaven there.
Yeah.
I mean, you've got, you know, Cheddar's not far away.
We're getting a cheese theme park made at the end of the year. The Cheeseopolis.
Sounds like my house.
So I know you wanted to talk about something in particular that's close to your heart. I'm going to stop the boys kind of winding you up here. So tell us a little bit about what you wanted to actually say this morning.
Well, it's Christmas time, a time of excess. Perhaps you've experienced that.
Yeah.
What do you mean?
I've joined forces with Coca-Cola to inspire people to think twice about all the packaging we throw away at this time of year. So what I've done, Coca-Cola are very keen to get people to start recycling plastic. They want all of their plastic packaging to contain 25% recycled plastic, and as people we're not recycling enough plastic.
It's a pain though, because a bit like I think
it's not just there, is
bin men get dead they love being fussy, don't they, like saying no, I shan't be taking that. That's cardboard from a beer bottle.
From a fiver, isn't it? Or is it, what do you give them at Christmas? Fiver, tenner?
I give them a kiss.
No, I've never tipped a bin man.
Really? Well, then they're one of their fussy.
I didn't realise you're supposed to do that.
You know, plastics that's something that we don't necessarily see as kind of beautiful.
Yeah.
Or having any value, really. But it just like glass or aluminium, is something that you can recycle. And to illustrate that point, I've done some baubles.
Oh, where's this going, Alex?
Are you okay, Alex?
I've made some baubles out of recycled plastic, which you can, if you go to the Coke Zone website, cokezone.co.uk, you can basically have one.
Can we have two?
And every time you order one, like Coca-Cola, give £5 to Together, the Climate Change.
Oh, that's good.
Now you're serious.
Oh, that's brilliant. That's good.
They're very nice. They're very tasteful. You know, they look good on your tree, definitely.
Oh, I love it.
I don't think Alex has been living the country life at all. I think you've been in, like, the Shetland Isles in a tiny little log cabin speaking to yourself. He's gone mental.
Yeah.
He has gone absolutely mental.
It just sounds so funny. You just say, like, we all started off really good, and then all of a sudden we're talking about baubles, which is fine, but we weren't expecting it.
They're nice baubles.
We'll leave it at that. Alex, one final question. It's been an absolute honour to have you on the show this morning. We have heard rumours that Blur may be getting back together. Is there any truth in that?
I don't know. I know Damon and Graham have kind of been hanging out a bit, which is I'm just really pleased that they're
chums
back on
again.
The same page. Chums again, exactly. Yeah. That's the main thing. So I don't think run before we can walk, but you know, watch this space. Who knows?
Personally, for me, it's been a huge honour to speak to you on the phone, fella, and we thank you so much for calling in.
And me, you sound absolutely lovely.
Yeah,
we're
off to buy some Stinking Bishop, Alex.
And some baubles.
Alex James, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah.
Back tomorrow from 6:30 on Bristol's GWR.